दिस इज लीवर विसरा, इट लाइज इन साइड द एब्डोमिनल कैविटी. Here you can see the quadrants. The right hypochondrium, epigastrium, left hypochondrium, right lumbar, umbilical, left lumbar, right iliac, inguinal, left iliac. On the basis of two vertical and the two horizontal line, vertical lines are passing through the mid clavicular line and horizontal line passing through the tip of the ninth costal cartilage first and then intertubercular plate. That is the tubercle of the iliac crest. And the lever lies at the right hypochondrium, epigastrium and a small part coming up to the left hypochondrium. This and this. These three quadrants. Okay. Now coming to regarding its anatomical position. Inside the abdominal cavity, in which way it lies. Okay. So the sharpest border. Sharpest border should face inferiorly. Convex surface should face on the right side. And this caval opening of the inferior vena cava should face straight upward. So I can't hold like this. Caval opening should face upward. Inferior border should face inferiorly. The surface border. And this we can't hold like this. Again this is a straight upward. But this convexity should face on the right side. So this is the anatomical position of the lever. Now the examiner will ask you, tell me about the lobe of liver. How many lobes? So there are two lobes, right lobe and the left lobe. Right lobe constitutes 5/6 of the liver. 5/6, and this is only 1/6. How will you divide liver into the lobes? It is divided on the basis of, this is falciform ligament, anteriorly falciform ligament and posteriorly ligamentum venosum. This one is ligamentum venosum and here is the ligamentum teres. Here this is ligamentum teres. So anteriorly falciform ligament and posteriorly but above ligamentum venosum and posteriorly but below is the ligamentum teres. On this basis of these three, position of this ligament, liver is divided. Right of that area is the right lobe and the left of that is the left lobe. Okay. Now, what is this? They will ask what is this and what is this one. So, this is the caudate lobe and this is quadrate lobe. It comes under which lobe? So, the dividing line is this. So it will come under the right lobe. What is this? This is gallbladder. Now they will ask, tell me about the surfaces and border of liver. It has got anterior surface, lateral surface, or you can say right lateral. This is superior surface. This is posterior surface. And here is the inferior surface. Inferior surface. Posterior and inferior all together known as visceral surface. And only one border, that is the inferior border. So how many surfaces? Anterior surface, right lateral surface, superior surface, posterior surface and inferior surface. Posterior inferior all together known as visceral surface. And only one border, that is the inferior border. Okay? They will ask, tell me about the ligaments of liver. Okay? So there are two type of ligament, true ligament and the false ligament. True ligament are the embryonic remnants. In the intrauterine life, they are different things. And now they are supporting to suspend the liver. Ligaments of liver. Okay? And the false ligament are peritoneal fold. So true ligament are two, that is the ligamentum venosum, this one, and here is the ligamentum teres. These two are true ligament. And false ligament is this one, falciform ligament. Here is the superior coronary ligament, this one. This is the superior coronary ligament. It attaches liver with the diaphragm. Here is the inferior coronary ligament. This one, inferior coronary ligament. Okay. And at the angle, it forms the right triangular ligament. Here also, left triangular ligament. And around the porta hepatis, here lies lesser omentum. In L fashion. Like this. So, these are the false ligament. That is the peritoneal fold. What are the false ligament? Falciform ligament. Superior coronary ligament. Inferior coronary ligament. This one, inferior coronary ligament. Right triangular ligament. Left triangular ligament. And the lesser omentum. The examiner will ask you, tell me about the structures of the porta hepatis. What is porta hepatis? Porta hepatis is the area from which the neurovascular structure enters or come out. Okay? The artery enters and the veins come out. Nerve is going, lymphatics coming out. So, this is the area that is called porta hepatis. What are the arrangement of a structure over there? And what are the structures? So, these are VAD. VAD. Portal vein, hepatic artery and the bile duct. Portal vein, P for portal and P for posterior. Most posteriorly is the portal vein. Then hepatic artery and then bile duct. Okay? There are the structures in the porta hepatis. Very important, what are the bare area of liver? What do you mean by bare area? Bare area is the area which is not covered by the peritoneal fold. All where there is visceral peritoneum. Around this viscera, there is visceral peritoneum. And only few areas where there are no peritoneal fold. They are known as bare area. Non-peritoneal area is the bare area. And they are, first, the bare area. This is most largest bare area. And it is regarded as the bare area. Proper noun, the lag gaya hai, okay, which is bounded anteriorly by the superior coronary ligament, posteriorly by the inferior coronary ligament, and the base is formed by anterior, posterior, and the base is formed by the fossa for the inferior vena cava. This is the, yahan pe fossa ho gaya, yahan fossa for the inferior, it loses the inferior vena cava, so fossa for the inferior vena cava. Or you can also say inferior vena cava. Okay? This is the bare area. Is there any other area in the liver which is devoid of peritoneal covering? Yes. There is underneath this gallbladder. This is known as fossa for gallbladder. It is devoid of peritoneal fold. So it is also the bare area. Not the bare area, bare area. Fossa of the gallbladder. Okay? Fossa for the inferior vena cava. In between the two fold of the falciform ligament. This is double folded. In between the two fold, there is no peritoneum. So, that is also bare area. Okay. Here, the fissure for the ligamentum venosum. Fissure for the ligamentum teres. Fissure for the ligamentum teres. This also comes under the bare area. Uske niche, waha pe koi peritoneal fold nahi hai. So these are the bare area. This much we have to know. Arterial supply is by the portal vein and the hepatic artery. Portal vein 80%, hepatic artery 20%. This is heart. This is heart. It lies inside the thoracic cavity. This is about the abdominal cavity. Above that is the thoracic cavity. So, heart lies in the thoracic cavity in the mediastinum. That is in between the two lungs. The space is called mediastinum, where it lies. Okay? The covering is known as pericardium. Pericardium, heart. That is two type of pericardium. Most outer one is the fibrous pericardium and inner one is the serous pericardium. It has got, first, it lies just behind the sternum and the left costal cartilage is 2nd to 6th. Okay? left side, and it has got apex. The examiner will ask you, there are how many surfaces of the heart. So it has got apex, base or posterior surface. This is sternocostal surface. This is lateral surface. And this is diaphragmatic surface. Apex, base or posterior surface, diaphragmatic surface, lateral surface, and the apex. Apex to bol hi diye, theek hai? Now, the examiner will ask you, tell me about the borders of heart. There is right border, inferior border, left border, bina puchha na, superior border. ठीक है, राइट बॉर्डर. व्हाट नाउ एग्जामिनर विल आस्क यू, व्हाट इज द एक्सटेंशन ऑफ बॉर्डर, फ्रॉम वेयर टू वेयर इट इज गोइंग. सो राइट बॉर्डर इज फ्रॉम द, दिस इज द सुपीरियर वेना कैवल ओपनिंग, दिस वन, एंड दिस इज द इंफीरियर वेना कैवल ओपनिंग. फ्रॉम सुपीरियर वेना कैवल ओपनिंग टू इंफीरियर वेना कैवल ओपनिंग, दिस इज द राइट बॉर्डर ऑफ हार्ट. फ्रॉम इंफीरियर वेना कैवल ओपनिंग अप टू द एपेक्स, this is the inferior border. From apex up to the left auricle, this is ear-like appendages, that is known as auricle in the left side, so left auricle. From apex to the left auricle, this is the left border. And from left auricle to the right auricle, again here in the right side there is one ear-like appendages. That is known as right auricle. Left auricle to right auricle, this is the superior border. Clear? Surfaces and border? Now the examiner will ask you, okay, you have told me these and these surfaces. Now tell me, what are the constituent of that surface? Do you know the right atrium, right ventricle, left atrium, left ventricle? Which one unite to form the surfaces? So sternocostal surface. It is formed by 1/4 right atrium. Up to this one is the right atrium. 1/4 right atrium, 2/4 right ventricle, 1/4 left ventricle, 1/4 right atrium, 2/4 right ventricle, 1/4 left ventricle. Sternocostal surface. What forms the diaphragmatic surface? It is formed by the right ventricle and the left ventricle, but the contribution of left ventricle is 2/3 and the right ventricle is 1/3. Clear?
Yes.
The lateral surface, it is formed by left ventricle as well as this left auricle. Apex, it is only formed by the left ventricle. Here is the left ventricle. So, and the posterior surface or base, it is formed by the right side right atrium, left side left atrium. But the contribution, left atrium 2/3 and right atrium 1/3. ठीक है? Right atrium 1/3 and left atrium 2/3. This is about the constituents. Now the examiner will ask you, okay, tell me what is this. So this is aorta. Where it ascends is the ascending aorta. It forming an arch. So this is arch of aorta. And after that it descend down. That from the descending thoracic aorta, in the thoracic cavity, in the abdominal cavity, there is abdominal aorta. Now the examiner will ask you, tell me about the branches of the arch of aorta. So this is brachiocephalic trunk. Only one brachiocephalic trunk is there. So no need to tell the right or left. So brachiocephalic trunk, which will give rise to, here is the right subclavian. Now you have to tell right subclavian and the right common carotid, which further is divided into external and internal carotid. एंड दिस वन इज यहां पे द लेफ्ट कॉमन कैरोटिड, दिस वन इज लेफ्ट कॉमन कैरोटिड एंड हेयर इट इज टॉर्न, दिस इज डिसेंडिंग, दिस इज इट फॉर्म्स ऑल्सो आर्च ऑफ एओर्टा एंड फ्रॉम हेयर द सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी इज कमिंग आउट. ओके, इट इज नॉट हेयर, ओनली कैरोटिड लेफ्ट साइड, लेफ्ट कॉमन कैरोटिड इज देयर, लेफ्ट सबक्लेवियन इज अब्सेंट बिकॉज द आर्च ऑफ एओर्टा इज ब्रोकन हेयर. ओके, एंड आफ्टर दैट डिसेंडिंग एओर्टा. वॉट इज दिस? दिस इज पल्मोनरी ट्रंक. इट गिव राइज टू इन द लेफ्ट साइड लेफ्ट पल्मोनरी आर्टरी, इन द राइट साइड राइट पल्मोनरी आर्टरी. दिस वन इज राइट पल्मोनरी आर्टरी. ओके, ओके, एंड दिस इज लेफ्ट एट्रियम, इज द सुपीरियर इन द सुपीरियर पल्मोनरी वेन, या सुपीरियर पल्मोनरी वेन एंड द इंफीरियर पल्मोनरी वेन. दीज आर टू सुपीरियर पल्मोनरी वेन and here is the two inferior pulmonary vein. Okay, opening into the left atrium, and I have shown the superior vena cava and the inferior vena cava opening into the right atrium. This comb like structure is the musculi pectinati. This vertical ridge is the crista terminalis. Just opposite to that there is a sulcus, that is called sulcus terminalis, and above that lies SA node. Okay, here is the depression, that is called fossa ovalis. If this remain patent, that is called the patent foramen ovale. This is right atrioventricular opening, which is guarded by tricuspid valve. This is papillary muscle. It gives like many cord like structure, corda tendinae. These are the cord like structure, which is attached to the valve, tricuspid valve. Clear? This is septomarginal band coming from the septa, coming to the root of the papillae. Septomarginal band is this. Okay. Now coming to another viscera. This is a spleen. It lies in the left hypochondrium. It has got two surfaces. That is the costal surface facing towards the ribs and the visceral surface facing towards the visceras. Two end, anterior end and the posterior end. Three border, that is the superior border, intermediate border and the inferior border. ठीक है? Examiner will ask you why this superior border is notched. Why? So it is the evidence of multinodular origin. Spleen is developed from fusion of multiple nodules and it is the evidence that it has got multinodular origin. Clear? Why spleen is known as organ of odd number? Because it is 1 inch thick, 3 inch breadth, 5 inch length, 7 ounce weight, and it is in relation with 9th to 11th rib. So all are odd number. That's why it is also known as organ of odd number. 1 inch thickness, 3 inch breadth, 5 inch length, 7 ounce weight, that is equal to 200 grams. Okay, and it is in relation with 9th to 11th rib. This is hilum of the spleen, from where the structures are coming out. Now examiner will ask you what are the ligaments of the spleen. In front of the spleen, it lies over the stomach, fundus of the stomach. So anteriorly there is a stomach and behind there is kidney. So gastrosplenic ligament, and posteriorly there is leno-renal ligament. Spleen is also known as leno. So leno-renal ligament, and this is gastrosplenic ligament, and here lies phrenicocolic ligament. It is not attached with that, just passing over there, and support to suspend it at that upper position. Okay? So these are the three ligaments of spleen. Now coming to kidney. This is kidney. The kidney, it lies in the four quadrant, that is in the hypochondrial, epigastrian, umbilical and the lumbar. लेफ्ट है, लेफ्ट का है तो लेफ्ट, लंबा राइट का है तो राइट लंबा, इसलिए लेफ्ट राइट नहीं मेंशन करते हैं, ठीक है? हाइपोकॉन्ड्रिया, एपिगैस्ट्रिया, अम्बिलिकल एंड द लंबर, फोर क्वाड्रेंट्स को ऑक्यूपाई कर रहा है वहां पे. नाउ द एग्जामिनर विल आस्क यू हाउ विल यू डिटरमाइन ऑफ विच साइड इट इज, एज दिस इज अ पेयर्ड स्ट्रक्चर. सो एंटीरियरली इट इज कॉन्वेक्स, पोस्टीरियरली इट इज फ्लैट. So this is anterior and this is posterior. Medially, it has got hilum that has concavity and laterally it is convex. So this is lateral and this is medial. And this is ureter. The upper part of the ureter up to the lower part of the kidney. This is known as pelvis. Up to this much is pelvis and after that it is known as ureter. This is renal pelvis. It lies posterior. We can't hold like this. Now it become anterior. It has to be posterior. So that is about the and it should go untwisted downward. If it, I will hang like this, it will twist. It is twisted. It should go twisted downward. Untwisted downward. देखो untwist है. तो ये left side क्या है? There are three things. First, the anterior surface is convex, posterior is flat. Medially it is concave and laterally there is convexity. And on the medial side, in the hilum, most posteriorly is the pelvis of the ureter, and it should go untwisted downward. So this is of left side. This much you have to tell for the side determination. Now the examiner will ask you, tell me about the covering of kidney. So it has got four cover from outside inward. There is from inside outward. I will progress from inside outward. First, there is renal capsule. Renal capsule, then perirenal fat. Then comes renal fossa and then pararenal fat body. Renal capsule, then perirenal fat, peri. Then comes renal fossa and then pararenal fat body. These are the covering of kidney. Okay. Now, the examiner will ask you, tell me about the arrangement of the structures in the hilum. This is BHAP. BHAP, that is the renal vein, renal artery, and the renal pelvis. From anterior to posterior. Very important. BHAP, renal vein, renal artery and the renal pelvis. These are the structure at the hilum. And most posteriorly should lie the renal pelvis. Now, this is stomach. It again in the left hypochondria, epigastria, and the umbilical. These three. Now, just remember a word, spoons. Just not looking like one spoon. So spoons, it has got two surface. As for surface, it has got two surface. That is the anterosuperior surface. Not only anterior, this surface is somewhat also superior in the anatomical position. So anterosuperior surface and the posterior inferior surface. There are two part. That is the cardiac part and the pyloric part. O for orifice. There is two orifice. This cardiac orifice and the pyloric orifice. Another O is very much similar to C. So this is not O. That is C. That is two curvature. It has lesser curvature and the greater curvature. Now the very important question comes. What is the attachment over the lesser curvature and the greater curvature? On the lesser curvature, there is lesser omentum. On the greater curvature, there are three ligaments. First, there is gastrophrenic ligament, then gastrosplenic ligament, and then greater omentum. On the lesser curvature, only lesser omentum. Gastrophrenic, connecting the stomach with the diaphragm. Gastrosplenic, connecting the stomach with the spleen. And then greater omentum. Okay? Spoons. Now, two notch. It follows the rule of two. Everything two in the stomach. Okay? Now, two notch. That is the cardiac notch. This one is cardiac notch. At the junction of the stomach and the esophagus. The lip border of the esophagus. And this is the incisura angularis. The most dependent part of the lesser curvature. Incisura angularis. Now, spoons. There are two sphincter. The cardiac sphincter and the pyloric sphincter. Okay? This much you have to know about the stomach. Now, coming to lung. What is this? This is lung viscera. Is this a paired or unpaired structure? This is paired structure. How will you determine this? First, the examiner will ask you, tell me about the surfaces and border. Okay? So this is costal surface. As it bears the impression of ribs. Ribs and the depression are due to the ribs and the elevation is due to the intercostal space. Like this. Okay? So this is costal surface and this is medial surface. Medial surface again divided into mediastinal surface and the vertebral surface. Okay? And this root of the lung comes under the mediastinal surface. This is mediastinal surface and this is vertebral surface because it lies along the vertebra. This is apex and this is base or diaphragmatic surface. Okay? So you have to tell these surfaces. Costal surface, diaphragmatic surface, medial surface, which is again divided into anteriorly mediastinal surface, posteriorly vertebral surface, and one apex. Examiner will ask you, tell me about the border. This is the anterior border. Thin, very thin. And this is inferior border. As it lies like this, so inferior border, this is semilunar. And this is posterior border. This is broad. Now, the examiner will ask you, how will you determine its side? Of which side it belongs to? Whether right side or left side? So, first we have to tell the side determination is not based on the lobes and fissure that right lobe contains. It is based according to its border and surfaces. That the anterior border is very thin. And posterior border is broad. So this is anterior and this is posterior. The conical part should face above. So this is superior. I can't hold like this. The conical part should face above. So this is superior and this is inferior. Inferiorly there is concavity. Okay. And in the laterally there is costal, convex costal surface having impression of ribs and medially, there is root of lung. This is how we can determine his side, whether it belongs to right side or left side. Okay? Now the examiner will ask you, why this is black? Why the lung is black? Due to the deposition of inhaled carbon particle. Okay? What is the nature of lung? It is the crepitus. It is soft and crepitus on touch. Why it is crepitus? Because it contains air cells. There is air inside that, and when we touch, it gives crackling sound. That's why it is crepitus. What is the medical legal importance of the lung? The examiner will ask you. If the baby has taken even a single breath, there is air inside the lung. So it will float in the water. And if baby has not taken even a single breath, that is stillbirth. So that will sink down in the water. This is very important medical legal importance of the lung. Okay, now the examiner will ask you, what is the difference between the right lung and the left lung? This is right lung and this is left lung. Just see the difference. Mostly, I have just few minutes prior, I have told that right lung not based on the lobes and fissure. But mostly, there is 3 lobes in the right side and only 2 lobes in the left side. This is superior lobe, middle lobe, inferior lobe. And only superior and inferior lobe in the left side. There are 2 fissures in the right side. This is the oblique fissure. This one is the oblique fissure. And here is the horizontal fissure. And only oblique fissure in the left lung. Right lung is somewhat taller, whereas the left lung is broader. In the right lung, there are 2 principal bronchus. Here you can see the hip arterial bronchus and the hip arterial bronchus. Above the artery is the hip arterial and below the artery is the hip arterial bronchus. There are 2 bronchus can be seen at the root of lung. And here, only 1 bronchus. This is bronchus. Here also, but these are variables, that's why I am telling. In the right side, there are 2 bronchus when it enters the lung, at the root of lung. Normally, in both sides, they divide the principal bronchus, the hip arterial bronchus and the hip arterial bronchus. But it divides early in the right side. That's why we see 2 openings in the right hilum. Okay? But only 1 opening. It divides, but inside the lung, in the left side. So these are the differences. The examiner will ask you, tell me about the relation of the structure at the root of lung. It is had. First vein, then comes artery, and then bronchus. Bhab. B-A-B. Bhab. Vein. How will you distinguish vein, artery, and here? Vein is collapsible. The anterior and posterior wall touches when we press it together. Okay? And this is elastic. Somewhat elastic. And bronchus is hard and cartilaginous. Bhab. So vein, artery and bronchus. And again, superiorly to inferiorly, there is ABB. First artery, then bronchus, and then ABB. Sorry. Superiorly to inferiorly, there is ABB. ABP news. Usse yaad rakhna hai. Artery, bronchus, and then inferior pulmonary vein. There are 2 veins, superior and inferior. ABB, artery, bronchus and vein. ABB. And anteriorly to posteriorly, vein, artery, bronchus superiorly to inferiorly, A, B, B, artery, bronchus, then vein. This is brain.
इतना बड़ा
क्या नहीं लोग ना बोले हो. This is cerebral cortex. This is dural fold. Dura meter, arachnoid and pia meter. There are three meninges. This is dural fold. Okay, very hard. Pia meter is this is arachnoid meter, and below that pia meter is going inside the feces. This is not going inside the fissure. You can see this layer, this meninges not going inside. So this is arachnoid meter. And when that meningeal layer, which is going even inside the sulci and gyri, that is pia meter. This is cerebral cortex that is divided by the median longitudinal fissure. Here is the central sulcus. Central sulcus hai ye. Yahan, this is central sulcus. This is frontal lobe, this is parietal lobe, this is occipital lobe, and here is the temporal lobe. Only this much you have to say. And just to show the sulcus. So see, this is central sulcus. And here is the, in between the two cerebral cortex, this is median longitudinal fissure. Okay? Now the examiner will ask you, tell me about the forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain. So, here the cerebral cortex, this comes under the forebrain, this is midbrain. Here is the midbrain, and this comes under the hindbrain. Hindbrain comprises of cerebellum, pons, and this one is medulla oblongata. Here it lies, medulla oblongata. ठीक है? Forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. The examiner will ask you, what is brain stem? So, midbrain, pons and medulla oblongata. These three unite to form brain stem. Very important. What cranial nerves are coming out from which structure? From forebrain. The two cranial structures are coming out. Two cranial nerves, sorry. This is olfactory. First cranial nerve. Olfactory nerve. This is optic. Second cranial nerve. These two are coming out from the forebrain. From the midbrain, third and fourth cranial nerve is coming out. This is broken. This is third cranial nerve. Okay. And fourth is coming from the posterior aspect. Okay. So this is third cranial nerve. Now at the junction of pons and medulla oblongata, this one, here is the sixth, seventh, eighth. This is the sixth cranial nerve. You can see this one is sixth abducens. Okay. Sixth cranial nerve. Here is the, this one is seventh cranial nerve, okay, facial, and this is eighth. This thicker one is the eighth cranial nerve, as it comprises of vestibular part and the cochlear part, vestibulocochlear nerve, eighth cranial nerve, 6, 7, 8 in the pontomedullary junction. Then 9, 10, 11, this is 11th cranial nerve. This one is 11th cranial nerve. This one. And here is the, this is 9th. 6, 7, 8. 9. And this one is 10. And this is 11. And the 12 and C1 is from this anterolateral sulcus of the medulla oblongata. ठीक है, यहां से आता है. कहीं कहीं पे है, यहां पे 12 था, दिखता भी था पहले. 12-1-C-1, ठीक है, इतना भर पूछा. नाउ ट्रस, अपर टू थर्ड इज द बॉडी, लोअर वन इज द सर्विक्स. दिस इज फेलोपियन ट्यूब, पोस्टरली दिस इज ओवरी, हियर इज आल्सो फेलोपियन ट्यूब एंड दिस इज ओवरी. दिस इज यूरिनरी ब्लैडर. दिस इज किडनी. सो दिस इज हाउ इट इज कनेक्टेड विद द urinary bladder, like this. Okay, and this is rectum. Okay, what's it mean?